Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Give me a second. Today we are finishing up a story we started a while back. A long time ago, back in season one of our reactions, I reacted to Deadpool. We then did Deadpool 2 a while later. And then during Superman, we did the first three X-Men movies and the New Mutants. And throughout this month, we have done the Wolverine, X-Men Origins Wolverine, X-Men First Class, Apocalypse, Days of Future Past, and Dark Phoenix. It's gone back and forth from being okay to just bad to awesome. But there was one movie in the Fox X-Men franchise we have yet to watch. And there was a reason I saved it for last. Because of the meaning of it. It is the final movie that stars Hugh Jackman as Wolverine. After being a main character in four of the seven X-Men movies with a cameo in another one, two of them, so not appearing at all in Dark Phoenix, and having his own set of movies, this is his swan song, as far as I'm aware of, Logan. People say it is a great movie. I'm here today to see how true that is. Because I have not seen Logan like the other X-Men movies. The only one I saw before I reacted to it was Deadpool 2. And I think the original Deadpool. That one though is, I'm not so sure about. That one's a bit more fuzzy. But I do know I have yet to see Logan. They're hiding out on the Mexican border. I don't know if that was the plot. That's actually something a little weird. There's the axe. Oh, they did the axe. They don't even care at this point. Ah, oh, man, I missed this intro. I guess it's mainly because I've just heard the Marvel fanfare so much this month, I'm just a little tired of it. Mangold? Thought I heard something, sorry, alright. Oh. Jesus. You can see his claws go through the guy's arm. That's what the all-in gets you. I'm pausing this quick. I actually want to Google this real quick. Hang on. Like, we've got the Deadpool movies, which got a little violent. Batman v Superman, which, eh. The Suicide Squad, Zack Snyder's Justice League. I don't have to be clones, wasn't weird at all, huh? don't think the Wolverine was rated R. Yeah, it wasn't. Constantine was rated R? Wow, okay, I was not expecting that one. You can tell Dark Phoenix was going to be a bad movie from the very beginning when you didn't have the X-Men theme song. X2, Days of Future Past and Apocalypse have the best X-Men theme songs. There's several, yes, but they're still the best ones. Who died? X-Men Origins Wolverine was terrible. The Wolverine was actually a pretty good movie, but it wasn't like a movie I would say is great. Wow. Well, at this point, we are barely into the movement. They already got that all waiting with the violence of the two F-bombs. Because I did fact check this today. If you drop an F-bomb in one movie, you can be still be PG-13. But if you drop two, you're automatically an all-rated movie. Oh, that's great. Thank you. I don't care. I got shorts. Right now my ears is bothering me.
Oh, man.
That's excuse in the F one, it's weird. Whoa! Oh, no. Glasses. He has to put on glasses. Old man Logan. This is the second time we've seen him. This time it's way more dark though. They said the Wolverine, he wasn't dying. All right, second the money. I give him credit. The kid hasn't even said a word. Oh no. That's not a good sign at all. Oh, this guy. Whoa. We're off the idiot right now. He's dead. Logan! And as soon as I get cut off. She's gone. Oh, she's not eating anymore. Oh, they do see her. What is he holding? Oh! Oh my God! Basically a kid Wolverine. Now you have to save us because he is a mutant, Logan. I'm liking this so far, alright. I mean, I don't know if this guy's our main villain or not, but we have our main plot. That's a good thing. Apocalypse took too long to do a plot, and it was a basic plot. Dark Phoenix was too much shambled together. Logan. Oh! Oh, Jesus! Oh, he still got shot! Her foot? Jesus! Oh, she knows what she has to do. This idea was a madman, but I love them for it. This is the most what the hell surreal movie. I love it. It's like an old western style movie. Ouch. I see how they're doing this. This movie is 100% violent and it knows it's violent. I love it at that point. Going hunting. He's still alive. trousers, I keep coming back. I can't with them. Skittles, Pringles, oh no. Oh no! She's gone. Poor guy, Scott for life. Poem of the day? That's true. That's not good. This is kind of sad. It's right now at like a slow moment. I'm liking that. X-23. That is his daughter. James Howlett. The Uncanny X-Men. I don't know why they're not making her say pretty much anything, but she showed a lot of emotion without talking. I love that. Some people can do that. Like, some people are actually mute, and they can still be expressive. As well. And it's like how he exists. This is why they gave me this an all-made-up movie, besides the violence, so he can just drop as, Hugh Jackman can drop as many F-bombs as he wants. Oh no. Oh my God, my head. Oh my God, somebody pose. Oh! Oh, this move doesn't count at all. Oh my God, even more. Oh my God. Even the mug got magnified. Yeah, I'm actually liking this Professor X more. He's a little bit more sassy in this movie. He's showing more emotion. Oh, wow, this is actually a heartwarming scene. Logan and Charles are having a good banter, but it's all good humor this time. Oh, no. Oh, no. It'd be hilarious if that's not the room they met. Had it. This feels disconnected from all the other movies, and that's not a bad thing. See, the Wolverine trilogy, the issue with that this trilogy is each movie is disjointed pretty much from each one. He's not getting that back, is he? Oh, I never got out. Oh, I have a shotgun. Was in wars. Oh my god, Patrick Stewart is just amazing in this movie. I said before, I liked the younger version more because of his, he showed more character, but damn, Patrick Stewart is doing a bang up job in this one. Why does this feel wrong? That's not Logan! Oh no!
Oh no, it's the guys from Polio!
Oh no! Last appearance of Wolverine, his daughter, and his clown. The claws look great right now. This is what I love about 2017 animation. Let me just took his family. Oh, no. Get out of there now. Oh, look, don't faint now. Does he still have the phone? Singing into it. And this is where they were, that was where it all on. Poisoning. She spoke. It's just not so bad. Oh no. Whoa, she can speak English. She got you there. Charles is keeping him alive. Oh my gosh, he's gonna drive. Wow, that was Pokemon must have a lot of swag. He's just watching him.
doing to him too. He could have left them, but he can't. Charles was right. Logan is a hero. They just like, they don't know what he said, though. Who is Old Man Logan?
yes! Oh, he's gonna. Is this gonna be like an epic shot of the two just doing it together? Yeah, it is. Yeah, there it is. Oh, this guy ended up killing him though. He's getting what he wants, but Well, that was a signal, clearly. Oh, no.
Oh, wow. Oh, my God. That is brutal, Jesus. It's not gonna walk. It's my team bullet. As soon as I put it in. Oh. You know what's a little ironic about this? He's dying with his pot in his hand. See what's his heart in the end. Yeah, I'll be completely honest with anyone here. I had no idea what she was saying for most of this movie because she was speaking Spanish. Jim Wee toy. Making an axe. And then Dark Phoenix had to come out at the end. So ends the story of Logan. There's a song called Blackout and Blacked Out for this movie. Weird. So that was Logan. The first 10 minutes, I was curious what was going on. And then it kept going. And the heartbreak continued. That was actually really good. It was brutal, which for an all rating, you want it to be brutal like that if you get an all rating. I'm sorry. You don't just get an all rating for no reason. You have to be extreme. The heart was there. Maybe I should have ended this month with this one. But I want to start this month how I end. I want to end it with how I started it. It's not a competition. This was, this was the best one. Which is a little bit of a hard thing to say because Days of Future Past and First Class were both really good. Plus the first two Deadpool movies are also really great. So here's hoping Disney does not script Deadpool 3.
join us tomorrow for something different than superheroes. See you guys then.